Working two jobs, decent salary, income coming in. But why does 1 + 1 equal -79 and I'm broke? What's going on? Hello there guys and welcome to The Break. My name is Patricia Bright. We're over here giving you the tools and resources to learn, grow, navigate life like a boss and make money moves in the process. I hope you are doing well. I am doing a video today for those of you who are in that situation. You've got income coming in, but you still feel broke. What on earth is going on? It's mind-blowing that you know that the resources are there, kind of, but it's not computing in the bank account. It's just not happening. So today I thought I would go over why that may be and how to make yourself feel less broke in these situations. So I'm actually gonna give some of you guys a bit of a break because you're not actually entirely going crazy. Inflation is going up. The fact that they are printing money like it is just water, the fact that interest rates are so low, life is becoming more and more expensive and your money is not going to be stretching as far as it used to. And many people are in very dire situation when it comes to their finances that make them feel even more broke. So you are not going crazy, particularly at these times. But we've got to take some responsibility sometimes because there's definitely things that are making us more broker than broke. Having no money goals is a recipe for disaster. Without a plan, the people perish. Your money is just walking with legs. Every online order, every Uber Eats is about to take your money away from you. It's literally growing legs and walking away. It's got no goal. You personally don't necessarily have a clear idea of what you actually want your money to do. Money can actually work for you if you tell it where you want it to go. You need to actually whip that money into shape. It's so important to set strategic goals when it comes to your money and your finances. And when you have these in place and you know what you actually want for your money, the chance of it just disappearing and vanishing into thin air is highly unlikely. When it comes to setting your strategic goals, you want to make them small and actionable. You want to think about securing yourself first with an emergency fund and a rainy day fund. Let's give a number like 2 months worth of rent and personal expenses. You want to put some money, an amount that you can commit to on a monthly basis to pay off any debts that you may have. And I always say it's really important to put some money away for financial fun. Having money set aside for handbags and holidays is, to me, a financial essential that makes me feel less broke. Having some form of direction and a goal for your money is a great way to make sure you don't feel broke and your money just doesn't disappear into thin air. Listen, I don't know if this should have gone first, but it's no money clarity. You're looking at your bank account like this. What can you see? Nothing at all. The money is coming, the money is going. It's just happening. Whatever's going on with your money, you don't know. How much you got coming in? Not quite sure. What's your tax? I don't know. What's your expensive? I don't know. Literally, you have no clarity on what's going on with your finances. It's silly. It's silly. It's like walking around a dark room and you know there are potholes that are gonna kill you. Like, no, don't do it. The only way to get financial clarity is, guess what guys, is to have a budget. Know what you have coming in versus what you have going out. And you know I have one of the best budgeters out there. You can download my spreadsheet when it comes to budgeting. Sit down. Spend 30 minutes to understand what your money looks like. Come on, why do we close our eyes to stuff like this? It is absolutely wild. But furthermore, pause the video now. Hit the like button, pause the video now, download the spreadsheet, and just sit down and look at your finances for a little bit. Come on. Do you know the difference between your income and outcome? What does that number look like? What happens if your expenses are a little bit higher 1 month? What happens if your income reduces 1 month? How does your life look? You don't have an idea of those figures, it's not cute. Honestly, if you wanna feel less broke instantly, it's literally taking control, opening your eyes and looking at the truth. Your numbers may not be perfect, that's absolutely fine, but the fact that you know what they are means you have taken control and it is game changing. This might sound a little hoo-ha, but I really believe in the power of a money mindset, and I really believe that a money mindset, a positive money mindset, is a privilege. If you were raised with parents who were smart with money and good and told you about saving and investing, you're in a great position. There are a lot of people people who were told they weren't going to be successful, they're going to be broke, life is really hard, you won't have any money, I'm broke, give me this, give me that. Like, that is a mindset that can really impact people even as they get into adulthood. If everybody around you is broke AF, it's really hard to feel like you can push out of those circumstances if that's the background that you've potentially come from. And if you've only seen brokenness and feeling of brokenness, boy, to break out of that is very, very difficult. And these are the things that aren't actually your fault, but there are things that you can do about it. It is important to get out of those negative monetary situations, those people who tell you it's not possible, those people and circumstances that maybe are asking too much when it comes to you and your finances, that maybe bog you down and make you feel more broke because you have to be responsible for other people. No, you may have to only be responsible for yourself and your kin, okay? And then you need to get into the mindset of learn, 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 grow, 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 add, 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 and abundance, abundance, abundance. I know it sounds crazy, but it's really important to change your mindset around money, and it will make you feel less broke. Even having a money mantra, like, there is plenty, I am worthy of it, I am successful, I am rich, even if you don't have anything, okay, even if you've got 2 pence to rub together, listen, rub those together, be wishing on the star, like, money's coming, the money's coming. Bearing in mind, my background is not from a rich background. One day I'll do a whole video and we'll talk about all of this. Like, no, listen, I've done the jobs, I've struggled, I've had noodles only for dinner, I know that struggle. And I come from that background as well. I realized it was really important for me to build a mindset of abundance and not one of lack. You can feel less broke instantly by changing your mindset and also seeing the examples of others. So here's a little bit of a practical tip, is that you may be using too many forms of payment. You got touchless, you got credit cards, you got Klarna, you've got Apple Pay, you've got this pay, you've got PayPal. It's like a scattergun approach. Your money is just going everywhere, anyhow, all the time. Every day of the week is just happening to you. And it makes you feel broke because you don't know whether you are coming or going, from which account this, from which account that. That payment is late, that payment is early. What's going on? It's basically the Wild Wild West in your bank account, and you don't want that to be the case. And if that is the case, it's time to consolidate and automate. Again, when it comes to personal finances and money, you have to take the time to just sit down and look at what's going on. And when it comes to consolidating and automating, you wanna look at all your income and basically make allocated or dedicated accounts. For me personally, I have all my expenses and bills coming out of one account, and I have a direct debit that goes out to that account. It's just automatic. I don't have to think about it. I don't have to schedule it in. It's just a direct balance. And every balance comes out of that allocation account. I then have also a savings account, and I also have an investment account, or multiple investment accounts. I even have a spreadsheet with all my accounts on them because I have so many different accounts. They all do different things, but they are all automated. It does take time, but you definitely will feel less broke when you are automating your payments and even setting all payments to happen on the same day. So that might be the day off the payday. Can feel very empowering and make you feel like you're less broke because you know what's happening when. If you can, make it the same day of the week, every single week, make it the same day of the month, every single month, and make sure you're on top of it and can just set it up so you have a system rather than something that feels like it's completely out of control. Yo, this is a good one. I know we're talking about not being broke, but some of us need to pay ourselves first, you know. Netflix has our money before us. This isn't wise. We have to learn to value ourselves, our time, and our money, that it's ours, and that it's important for us to invest that into ourselves first. You receive a salary, and then your salary just goes everywhere else. But you need to really think about, fine, you've got to pay your expenses, but you need to pay yourself first to feel really comfortable. And that might be investments into yourself. It might be your learning or your training or a savings account. Even if it's like £50 or $100 a month, it doesn't really matter. But the fact that you make almost like a commitment and a promise to yourself, it makes you feel less broke, and that other people can wait. Those online purchases can wait. You need to pay yourself first. Make that commitment to yourself. And even if that money is to enjoy yourself, that's up to you. If that is gonna make you feel less broke, then do it. And I'm not gonna sit here and say, be frugal, don't have fun, don't have fun, because I like a shoe and a bag. I'll be honest with you. I do like the good stuff. However, all in moderation. You might be feeling broke because everybody else looks like they're rich. Oh, we are coming back to it. That sickly disease, keeping up with the Joneses, ISIS. We need to take a temperature check over there. Let's keep it real. We live in a world where we are constantly seeing so many people with amazing things all the time. You're seeing people's highlight reels of holidays, not really in COVID life, but holidays, great experiences, new clothes, latest gadgets, everything. And you feel like, man, I don't have any of these. Or even worse, you're just trying to keep up and you're spending all your money based on consuming these things that you're seeing other people with. And that's going to make you broke or make you feel like you're broke. It's a fact. We've all suffered with it. We've all been culprits. We've all shared things that we absolutely love. Like, I share a cute bag, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna tell you that I've accepted I'm an oxymoron. I like new things as well as I like saving. Okay, it is what it is, right? However, if you find that it's becoming detrimental to yourself, switch it off, unfollow, block it, focus on building your bag so you don't feel broke. But honestly, I think the pressure to keep up in the society that we live in is so hard if you do not have strength of character. And that's not a bad thing. We all think that we are so strong and we can handle it, but we don't realize that we are being influenced by what we're seeing all the time. Switch it off and instantly you might even feel richer and less broke because you'll probably have more time on your hands to invest in yourself as well as in the stock market. Finally, you are relying on one source of income. I know right now it's very difficult. The job market is actually changing so much. There's less work available. The security of the one job situation is over. It's done and dusted. But there's also a lot of opportunity to have side hustles and passive income. Gone are the days of just sitting down and hoping your job is secure and is there. No, honey. You're gonna feel less broke when you know if one fountain dries up, you still have another stream as well. You need to build up your multiple sources of income, passive income as well, but be willing and ready to upskill yourself and to learn more to be able to offer services, build businesses, and make more money. I don't think that anyone feels that comfortable with just one source of income anymore. And that may be one of the reasons why you feel broke. To change that, upskill and look at the ways that you can make those side hustles work for you. Ain't no shame in the game. Ain't no shame in the game. If you feel broke, I felt broke. I know many people who are broke. That's okay. The key thing you wanna do is do something about it. You don't have to stay broke in 2021. You can increase your income and you can drop your expenses, but you really wanna take control to feel better about it. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. Let me know in the comments if you're feeling broke or if you're not feeling broke. Let us know why you're not and what you're doing about it. But in the meantime, you can catch me over on the Break Instagram and we will catch up later. New videos will be coming out actually every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday because I want to be a consistent queen for the family. And gay breakers, I'll see you all later. Bye.